Hi everyone. Today I have this Bowers & Wilkins 706S2 for review. This one is retail for around $1,800 for a pair of these. This is one of the high price bookshelf speakers. Build quality is very good as usual. Top notch build quality from Bowers & Wilkins. I have the grill on this one. This is a magnetic grill. This grill is kind of thin. A little bit flimsy. Right now I'm looking through the bass tuning port. I can see the light through there. So probably that's due to the color of the driver or due to the the new technology that they created. The build quality, I mean, nothing to complain. This is a good build quality as it should come with this price point, $1,800 price point. Overall build quality is one of the best. And let's get to the sound quality. How good these can sound compared to other speakers, or I will have the comparison review with the KEF LS50 speakers in different video. Today I'm going to focus on this speaker alone. So overall sound quality is very clean, detailed, transparent, very good amount of music inside that I can hear. I can hear a lot of details that I wasn't hearing before, but it's not analytical, it's very musical sounding speakers. So this tweeter is the best tweeter ever they created for this price range and this particular series, which is really smooth and transparent and detailed and pinpoint stereo image that are, you know, it's so crazy good. So high frequency. Some people may call it a bit more forward, but please keep in mind, this one is not as forward as a 707. Probably that's due to the bigger bass driver and higher frequency balanced out. So that's how I have experienced. So high frequency is less pronounced than the 707S2, more balanced sound. And overall, sound is so good. Everything. From top to bottom, detail frequency is very good. I mean, I don't think you can have better speaker than this in this price point. High frequency, I can have all the details that I want to hear. I'm hearing more details than I'm hearing with my KEF LS50 speakers, but not analytical. It's very musical sound. So mid-range. Mid-range is the best mid-range, best natural mid-range that you can get. Vocals, every instrument in the region is very natural and very clean, very realistic, and very convincing, more evolving into the inside of the music. So I can, you know, totally enjoy listening my music in that soundscape. That's how good these speakers produce the sound. It may not be the biggest soundstage, but it does provide very decent soundstage with the good, accurate tone quality. High frequency, mid-range, very good. And bass performance, very clean, very fast. There's no muddiness or there's no wobbling sound or no looseness or anything like that. It's very taut and fast and very clean with very good amount of definition. More definition than you will hear from any other speakers in this size and price of the speakers. That kind of sound quality from top to bottom, probably the best that you can have for this price. But for the price wise, $1,800, I'm pushing my limits because 707 S2 convinced me that it go up on the line, which... Oh, by the way, I have to update some information. I no longer have a BSP P5. I no longer have 707 S2. So I still have my KEF LS50s. So I'm going to be doing the comparison review as well. So that is just a little bit of update on my current speaker lineup. So this one become one of my favorite speakers of all time because very natural, very clean, and a lot of musical insight that I can hear in my system. Probably this speaker is going to replace my KEF LS50 speakers, but I will keep on doing my audition because I kind of like that warmish mid-range tone from a KEF LS50 speakers, which is a bit more evolving than this one, but they are either or I can live with it. So I have to choose one based on my preference. If I'm really fall in love with these speakers, I might be doing going back to Accuphase lineup. For now, I'm totally enjoying the speakers. One of the best speakers that you can buy for your money, and it will hold the volume even in the long run. This is a wood grain finish that beautifully done. It's a roll snap finish. Look at the driver, it looks beautiful and gorgeous. And this tweeter become one of my favorite tweeter. I like this kind of speakers, like especially like Bowers & Wilkins or KEF, because they are all about innovation. They are all about making the components better. Because if you look at the driver and everything, the tweeter assembly looks like something out of spaceship. And the bass driver is high-tech material that they created. It's called a Continuum cone, bass cone driver. So, and also this tweeter is double dome tweeter with carbon coated on top of it. So, which means state-of-the-art new technologies that I really enjoy in this kind of speakers. Although I like the old school speaker as well, but you know, for my critical music listening, I kind of prefer this kind of a highly resolution, detailed sounding musical speakers. Probably if I keep this speaker, I'm gonna upgrade the jumper to a better copper jumper or something. So that's about it. So this speaker is beautiful to look at it, great sounding speakers. I can totally live with. I'm almost in love with this speakers, to be honest. So I'm gonna be keep doing a comparison with my LS50 in my music den. Then I will keep you guys updated, and I will also do the comparison review with the KEF LS50 speakers with this one. So this is my quick review of a Bowers & Wilkins 706 S2 and So a track that I play is called I Love You More Than You'll Ever Know from Vanessa Fernandez Use Me album. This is one of the better recording albums that you can buy. So here's a little update. This speaker, Bowers & Wilkins 706 S2, I am very happy to announce that this speaker is going to replace my KEF LS50 speakers for my music listening duties. So this is my new reference speaker for my music listening. The KEF LS50 is dethroned or replaced by 706 S2. This is my quick update. And then a few more things. You got to be patient with this speaker because it will take about 300 plus hours to get the natural sound signature. I was amazed at how much they transform after 300 plus hours of usage. And then previously I said the sound stage was smaller, but like, you know, after that break-in period, probably the biggest sound stage you can have for this kind of mini monitor speakers, probably as big as a tower speaker. Because if you don't see it, you're not gonna know you are hearing the sound from a mini monitor speaker. That's how the sound stage and dynamic range is good, especially impact and bass performance. Absolutely everything you can ask for this kind of price range. This is the bottom of 706 S2 speakers. Purpose of those four metal mounts, you know, if you want to screw it down on your speaker stands, you can screw it down. by using like M6 20 thread screws. Looks like it's going to work with my old Bowers & Wilkins 24 inch stands holes right there. So this hole matches exactly on the bottom of 706 S2 speakers. I'm only doing this when I choose a speaker to use it as the reference or standard speaker. I thought about getting the new stands that they made, but looks like my old stands work out perfectly fine. I'm gonna flip it upside down, the speaker stand, so you guys can see it clearly. The holes, all the holes line up perfectly. So all I need is these M6 20 thread screws. So this is how I'm going to mount it. So I'm so happy that these are bolted on to my favorite stands, because since I decided to keep a 706 S2 as my reference everyday music listening speakers. So this is it, all set. I just want to share this information. Thank you for watching and happy listening.